our way to Amicalola.
Those two got up extra early to drive us, even though we're driving.
Usually out on the trails, but today I got some tendonitis, so they make me just.
Today?
Yeah. No, just
we'll
like
have at least
total.
Like one or two people on the trail at some point. I think that the only
here we go. We're on the approach trail. Our packs are way too heavy.
Okay, we made it to the approach trail. Whew, I'm ready to look tired. We haven't even left the parking lot. Our packs are way, way too heavy. We'll probably be dishing stuff. Mine's like 30 pounds.
37.
Do I see you?
Oh, there you are. How much?
37.
Oh, 37. Wish us luck.
This approach trail is no joke. So we've only gone 3 miles, but add 2 to that, so maybe 5 miles. So. Huh, we're like halfway done for the day.
White blazes for days. We're white blazing through the trail.
Finally hit the 80. We'll only do like 2.5 miles, 2.8 actually, until our shelter, and then call it an early day to not overdo ourselves and push it to exhaustion. And we've got to our first water crossing. Sun came out. Getting warm. Our camp for the night. Little spot. Shelter's over there. And there's only like one other person here because it's 4 o'clock, but we are done for the day.
Good morning, everybody. day two on the Appalachian. I guess it's actually the first full day here. Yesterday, just in case anybody was confused, we did the approach trail, which is about 8.8 miles that leads up to the Appalachian Trail. So most of our mileage yesterday wasn't even on the AT. It's just like one of those things that is kind of a rite of passage. Most people do the approach trail because getting to Springer, the summit is a little bit challenging and you have to park and then backtrack up. So most people just do the approach trail, which is 604 stairs and then uphill about over 2,000 feet elevation, which it wasn't terrible, but it was kind of a long day, especially getting used to it with our packs. So hopefully today will be good. So we'll be checking in later. So what I'm learning is anytime there's a gap, like Horse Gap or Cooper's Gap, it's always a huge climb out of it. A big descent into it and a huge ascent out. But the views are great. We still have to go, oh wait, all the way up there, somewhere up there.
Well, good morning, everybody. Day three, coming out of Gooch Gap. Still on the fence about how far we're going in today. There's an issue with needing a bear canister, and well, we don't have those. So we'll see what we do. We're gonna either do seven today, or we might do, no, I think it's like 16 or 15 or something. Rain's coming in sometime, probably later on tonight, and yeah, we'll keep it posted. Let's have a good day. And this is why we do this, for these awesome views.
Hit Woody Gap today. Crossing the street. Blood Mountain.
But these views today, glad we pushed it. Even though it was a hard climb, and I know it's gonna be very hard going down for our last couple miles of the day, but better than doing this in the rain.
You see, these are the shoes.